Shared storage is a very important component of VMware infrastructure that allows you to use the features like vMotion and high availability when you have a host failures. So in this session, I'm going to go through three important topics of VMware which you need to know, starting from what is a data store, which you need to understand as a virtualization admin, why do you need shared storage, and then the importance, what are the different storage protocols. Welcome back everyone, this is Ibrahim Quraishi here, and this is session 15 of VMware tutorial for Vigram. Just wanted to remind you all to subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the notification button, because today I have decided that I'm going to post two sessions every week. One is going to be Monday 10 o'clock and one is going to be Thursday 10 o'clock Greenwich Mean Time. Alright then, let's get started. As discussed, we are going to go through three topics today. What is data stores? What is a data store? Second is, why do we need shared storage? We are going to deep dive and understand the necessity of why we actually require shared storage. And then last but not the least, we are going to go through storage protocols, and then I'll go through the demo on my vCenter to show you obviously the different components of storage. Also on my lab, I'm running FreeNAS with iSCSI. If you guys want to see the setup, how to do it, you want me to do a video on it, comment at the comment on below and let me know, and then I can do a video on how to create the storage using FreeNAS. Okay, so what's a data store? Storage basically is for you as a important ingredient for running your virtual environment. So the same goes with networks. Obviously, for your virtual environment to run healthy, you need to have healthy ESXOs running, obviously having good capacity, and you have to have a healthy storage. And then to connect to your storage, you need to have a network which doesn't have latency or any, you know, packet drops. So you need to have a healthy network as well. So they are the main components which you need to have. So when we talk about storage, we often hear the name LUN, which is logical unique number. From the storage world, they are quite famously known as LUNs, but in the VMware world, or if you are a VMware admin, you call it a data store. The LUN is presented to you, and once it's done, the masking is done and it's presented, you can see it, you can scan it and attach it in your virtual environment, and it's called a data store. You can present NFS storage as well from any storage and start using it as a shared storage as well. The second thing is data store presentation as a LUN will be formatted into a file system. So by default, if you're not using vSAN, which is another product of VMware, your LUN which is presented will be formatted in a file system. So up to 6.5, sorry, up to 5.5 and even 6, we had VMFS 5, and from 6.5 we have got VMFS 6. So there will be a new session which I'll be doing just talking about VMFS file systems. Be sure to watch it. I think that will be the next session. So let's move on quickly. VM actually runs on your storage, so on your data store really. So that's why it is important to understand how storage connects, how storage works, what are the protocols, and so on and so forth. So let's deep dive into this now. Okay, why do you need shared storage? That was the second question I said in the agenda. So as I said, your VM runs on the storage, so it's very important for us to understand. The second thing is, you will be able to use features like vMotion. So if you have a couple of hosts, you have a shared storage which you're using to store your VMs or your obviously using in your environment, then you can leverage features like vMotion. What is vMotion? Basically, you're moving a VM, a powered on virtual machine which is running on a ESX host, from one machine, from one ESX host to other while it is running. That's called vMotion. And you can only make it possible, you can only do this vMotion if you have a shared storage. So I hope I'm making myself clear. We can obviously do a little demo as well today, but and talk about it. So the next thing which you will achieve is high availability. So another feature, another important feature of VMware is high availability. So what is high availability means? If you have a host failure, HA, high availability agent, will make sure the VMs running on that particular host power on. Now the way it is possible is because all the storage is available to all the hosts in the cluster, and hence why the VMs will be able to power it on. So that's high availability for you guys. Okay, as I promised, storage protocols. So I'm going to discuss couple of them: FCOE, Fiber Channel Over Ethernet, and this basically is, again, you need to have licenses with Cisco. If you're using a Cisco kit for running fiber channel, you need to have a HBA card, because fiber channel requires obviously HBA cards for your environment. Of course, you will get good traffic because it's a dedicated traffic for your data, really, for your storage. So you're going to see improvement. The other alternative, the cheaper alternative, is iSCSI. So you're just using your Ethernet IP traffic and pushing your storage or your storage data over your IP traffic. So you're using iSCSI. That can also be achieved. I have seen most of the small companies, they are moving away from FCOE because of the licensing cost, and they are using they are starting to use iSCSI. The alternative option is also NFS. Again, NFS using your normal iSCSI Ethernet, I guess you can connect using NFS and NFS share and start storing with virtual machine on your NFS shares and use it like a shared storage. Okay then, so that's the main topics which we wanted to cover. So the setup I have at lab is, I have a cluster of host, and then we have some storage here. So one host is connected to all three of the data stores, and then the second host is connected to all three of the data stores. So in an event this host dies, and if it is running a machine X here and Y, so those machines are actually stored in the storage. If this fails, the VM basically will be left powered off. Obviously, you'll be having a crash on the VM because the host crashed, the VM will crash. But HA will take care of it. HA will identify that the VM has powered off. There will be a heartbeat running among these hosts. The heartbeat will fail, and as soon as there is a host isolation, it's called host isolation, it will try and check whether the VM has locks. If it doesn't, then those VMs will be powered on the host which has access to the storage. Again, if you zone this particular one and you don't have access to this storage, so what will happen is you won't be able to power it on. Simple as that. So let's go back to paint here. And then draw something. Let's take the pen. So in a situation you have this particular storage which is not zoned here and only here, then if there is any VM sitting here and the host crashes, then it won't be able to power on this host 103. So that's another problem. So that's why all the storage presented in the cluster should be presented to all the hosts presented in the cluster as well. It doesn't matter if you are having a data store cluster or not, but obviously even if you are having three storage, then you have it. The advantage of having a data store cluster is the VMs also move over using storage vMotion. That's another concept which you need to understand. So a VM could be sitting here where the data store is filling up, and this is a free one, so it moves a couple of VMs from here to here. It's similar to vMotion. vMotion happens on the compute level, and data this storage vMotion happens on the storage level, on the data store level. Okay, so I was planning to do a quick demo so that you can understand a little bit more. Let's quickly jump into that. on home, and then on the home button you'll see storage. If you click on storage, you'll see all the storage. So these are the local storage, local disk attached to the host. So FreeNAS, so this is the one which is the shared storage available. If I click on the shared, if I click on the storage and I click on host, you can see the host which I have presented this data store. So I have three hosts presented to this data store. And if I click on VMs, I can see all the running VMs on this data store. And if I click on files, I can see all the VMDKs which are stores here. So if the server has a VMDK VMX file running on the same and the main VM file running on the same LAN, then or the data store, then you will see the VM registered here and running here as well. Does it make sense? Yeah. Okay, that's about it, guys. So I hope you understand the topic. So we covered why do we need like what are data stores, why do you need shared storage. The important reason for shared storage is you will be able to leverage features like vMotion and HA because of that. In the next, in one of the sessions, coming sessions, we'll be doing the vMotion demo, and we'll try and see HA as well, how we can do high availability, how we can get high availability to work. So stay tuned for those. So let's go back to my PowerPoint. As always, you can reach out to me on Twitter at Ibrahim Quraishi. My blog is ibrahimquraishi.com. I'm also working on a new blog, which is agileops.co.uk. So be sure to check that out as well. I'll just quickly show you this. And this blog is going to be curation of other bloggers, IT bloggers, especially oriented to virtualization. So you can put your name and leave your email address and subscribe, and then I'll be posting out weekly newsletters. So I'll be having this as my main blog going forward. I will be redirecting Ibrahim Quraishi to Agile Ops as well. And also you'll be seeing the curated content coming in. I am actually trying to curate all the top virtualization bloggers and have it on a single page for you guys. So hope you'll find that easy to use and enjoyable as well to read. So be sure to subscribe on my blog as well, Agile Ops. I'll leave the link in the comments below. So today's question of the day is, why do we need shared storage? So if you remember, I said we need it because so many options. There are three important features why we need it, reasons why we need it. Two of them are to leverage VMware technology. So I hope you remember it. Message on the comments below right now and let me know that you've been listening and you've been understanding the technology. We are almost done nearly 50% of the course which I wanted to deliver. Thank you very much for subscribing. For the guys who have subscribed and you haven't subscribed, please subscribe now and comment on below and let me know. And also comment on below and let me know if you want to see how to set up FreeNAS, FreeNAS with the iSCSI, the software FreeNAS with iSCSI. I have it running in my lab, and I think it will be an interesting video to create and show how to configure it for your home labs if you guys want to use it as a home lab. Okay then, don't forget to subscribe and enjoy watching and keep sharing, guys. Cheers, bye.